sloppy paperwork. Late 7 times. We both know that means the truer figure's closer to 24.
I don't follow your logic, sir.
Don't be smart, Bevis. You're a probationer. Sergeant Keegan will have bent over backwards to give you a clean sheet.
Yes, sir.
On 4 occasions you missed parade altogether. Alarm clocks too technical, are they? Maybe you should have done a science degree.
There were reasons, sir.
Not reasons, excuses.
You about ready to check the prisoners?
What's the rush?
Oh, it's Matt.
Huh?
Push off early, tomorrow's Saturday.
How come you managed to screw a Saturday off?
It's not what you know. Wife's birthday.
Oh, yeah. Gotta play a bit clever on that front, didn't you?
It's pretty quiet. Got rid of the last bucket of mop job half an hour ago. Fighting. With this one.
Is that slack still here?
Just shut it.
Looks a bit young.
Swears Blanche's 18. That's me, it's jailbait.
Well, you could have checked.
What, and waste half the morning? It's not as if we're going to charge them.
What am I supposed to do them?
Let them cool off, slap the backsides, chuck them out. Think you can manage that?
It's entirely up to you how much you pledge, sir. That most people have gone for the pound, the mile. Thank you, Mr. Brownlow. Very generous, sir. You wouldn't happen to know if Chief Inspector Kate was in this...
You're talented, able. Sergeant Keegan reckons when you put yourself out, you're very popular on the relief.
Thank you, sir.
But this isn't a part-time job. Something you can do when you feel inclined.
Sir.
Nobody expects you to get everything right straight away. That's what the probationary period's about. But what we do expect is attitude.
Sir.
Equally, it gives us time to sort the wheat from the chaff. Do you understand what I'm saying? Right. No one said it was going to be easy. That's why we rely on being professional. Disciplined.
Is that right, sir? We're all professional, are we?
Meaning?
Meaning maybe my report can be read in 2 ways. Maybe it says more about Sergeant Keegan than it says about me.
In what way?
Well, if you want to know why I got such a lousy report, perhaps you ought to ask him. Ask him what little extras he wants late at night, tucked up in a panda.
What are you saying, Bevis?
I'm not saying, I'm asking, sir. Trying to get your leg over? That's professional behaviour, is it?
Hollis, go! Shut the door, sit down.
I can't help you.
Why not? It was our officers picked you off the floor, Dean. You were the one getting your face altered. Who did it? What was it, an aggrieved punter? An argument over territory? Well, it certainly wasn't about cash, was it?
What do I need territory for?
You're a pimp, Dean.
Says who?
My information says that you specialise in young girls. Straight off the train at King's Cross. Easier to scare, are they?
I am not running any girls.
So who attacked you then? I've got a witness, Dean. Says he saw a beige Nissan speeding away. 2 aerials. What's that, a minicab? Mean anything to you?
Perhaps he was looking for a fare.
You spend much more time listening at keyholes, whereas you get rusty ears.
No, that was a bit difficult not to hear. Bevis was giving Kate her right ear bashing.
You're putting 2 and 2 together and making 12 again, Reg.
I don't know. Keegan's not exactly immune to wandering and trouble, is he?
And he won't kick Karen out of bed.
What?
She's a looker, Polly. If Keegan's getting a piece of it, good luck to him.
Forget it, Polly. He's on a wind-up.
Yeah, well, it's putting temptation in your way, isn't it?
Well, a probationer's in his charge, so she's fair game, is she?
You said it.
Going OTS is hardly a criminal offence.
Yeah, that's right, isn't it, June?
Why not wait until we know the facts before we lynch him, eh?
Nah, lynch him first, ask questions later. It's more fun.
Afternoon.
He didn't come straight out. That's not how it's done, is it, sir?
But Sergeant Keegan gave you the impression... A good report was dependent upon your consenting.
Not even consenting. Just not saying no.
WPC Bevis, you're making serious allegations. I need to know what actions you want to take. If we go to the grievance procedure, it could result in disciplinary action against Sergeant Keegan. Is there any way you could have misread the signals?
I'm not imagining it. It's my career up for grabs as well, sir.
June.
Sarge?
What's the excitement?
Oh, it's just a couple of the lads mouthing off, you know.
About? Look, if something's causing ructions with the relief, I think I ought to know about it.
It's not this relief, Sarge. It's B relief. The rumour has it that Karen Bevis has put in a complaint against Sergeant Keegan. Harassment.
I see.
I mean, it's still gossip. It'll probably just fizzle out.
You reckon?
Well, either way, couldn't happen to a nicer bloke.
Dean Cochrane. Assault, unlawful imprisonment, procuring. 5 complaints in the last 8 months.
But nothing that sticks.
No. Statements withdrawn. 1 minute the girls are showing me their scars, the next they're back with Cochrane, all sweetness and light.
Well, that's par for the course, Alistair.
All I need is for one of the girls to stick to her story. Give me some leverage with the others.
What about the assault on Cochrane?
He doesn't want to bring a complaint. Won't say who hit him.
Well, there's no crime then.
Yeah, right. Got a bit edgy when I mentioned the car, though.
What car?
Witness reported a beige Nissan Stanza at the scene of the attack. Reckoned it was a minicab.
Any description of the driver?
Yeah, Asian, early 40s, anorak and glasses.
She does realise the sort of grief this could lead her into, does she?
I couldn't say, sir.
Well, perhaps somebody should enlighten her, Philip.
Yes, sir.
What about Keegan?
I'm about to have a word with him.
Yes, you do that. I want Keegan to clearly understand I will not tolerate that sort of behaviour in my station.
Aren't we jumping the gun, sir? Innocent till proven guilty.
Unless you're wearing a uniform. He's put the years in, he knows that.
Go easy, that's all I'm saying, Ray. You've been Sergeant's Fed rep for 5 minutes, that's all.
Yeah, but if it goes to disciplinary...
We don't know that it will. It's all new procedures.
I just want to get ahead of the game, Bob.
Well, that's fine. But maybe this is something that could be sorted with a quiet word. And you go charging in there, waving the Fed flag, and it could have the opposite effect. And anyway, you've got to think about yourself.
How do you mean?
Well, this is your neck, Ray. You've got to work here afterwards. And you have to decide how far you're going to push this thing for Len Keegan.
Getting the reliefs back up, you mean?
That's worth a thought.
Yeah.
This is a joke. Dragged out my car, told to hang around for half an hour. Now the old man wants to see me. You and all, Ray. Let's rattle this cage.
All right, Annie, see you off.
Suppose I wanted to say something. Report it.
Front office, love, they'll sort it.
It's about my boyfriend. There's someone out to get him, see. Wants to hurt him bad.
Why is that? What's your boyfriend's name?
Dean. Dean Cochrane.
I never touched her, sir.
No? She's an attractive young lady.
No way. It's the name of the game, isn't it? Look but don't touch.
So you fancied her?
That's not what he said, sir.
Karen Bevis is a graduate. Isn't that right?
Sir? Sociology.
That's useful. She's still marked down for great things, though. Fast-track promotion.
So?
So, there you are. Puppy walking a fast-track plonk. Making sure she doesn't tread on anything nasty. And a few years down the line, you're going to have to be calling her mom.
I can cope with that, sir. I don't have to like it, but it doesn't get in the way of me doing the job.
Really?
I could have given her a good report, yeah. But it'd have been lies, sir. A cover-up.
Oh, so she's a write-off, is that what you're saying?
Karen's just not cutting it, sir.
So why spend so much time with her? Smacks of association.
I still think she could do it. Be a good copper, I mean. Just needs to give herself a chance, that's all.
You're the man to teach her.
Boyfriend? Who's she kidding? Dean Cochran's a pimp.
Might be Jackie doesn't know the difference yet.
So who she say is out to get Cochrane?
Some minicab driver. Won't give a name, won't say what it's about. But it seems genuine enough.
Well, she's got a good cause, Matt. Just a bit slow off the mark, that's all. Cochrane's in St. Hughes. Major repair work to his face and ribs.
Right, carry on.
Sir.
Ray?
Sir?
Door. Not doing himself too many favours. What do you think?
There's not a lot I can do, sir. Until the complaint's made official. If it gets that far.
Keep your head down. Hope it blows over.
Something like that. Off the record, sir.
Go ahead.
I'm not sold. I'll give Keegan backup, but it doesn't mean I have to believe him.
Thanks for letting me know.
Sir?
It's just that I've always wondered what the Fed was for. A freebie sergeant's meeting every 3 months, isn't that it? A session with the lads.
No, sir. But I don't see it's my job to bust a gut for someone like Keegan.
Oh, is that right? I'll remember that when the first accusation comes your way.
Can I ask you a question, sir? What was I doing here? Sergeant Keegan's got no need for representation.
Maybe I was hoping you'd talk some sense into him. Maybe I'm trying to confront this as a partnership, right?
If I bring a grouse to you, overtime, manning up, or whatever, it's nothing I can do, Ray. Leave it to the management, Ray. And now all of a sudden we're a partnership.
One of your fellow sergeants has been accused by a WPC. And whether we like to admit it or not, that means he's as good as damned straight away.
He'll get a chance to defend himself.
Oh, will he? I don't think so. A female officer accusing one of the blokes. No. Fact, Ray. He can't win.
But Dean looks after the money, doesn't he? And he sets you up with punters.
No. I'm not saying nothing against him.
He's your punts, Jackie.
That's insulting.
What are you telling me, then?
He's nice. Sweet.
Sometimes.
Lots of times.
Tell me about the girl you were fighting. Is Dean nice to her, too?
Yeah.
So he lied to you. Said that you were special.
Yeah.
Can't it be nice to find out there were other girls? All of them special, too.
Made me angry.
Of course it did. Tell me about the minicab driver, Jackie.
Just takes us to the punters hotels, waits outside, does what he's told.
So why is this driver after Dean then, Jackie? Doesn't he like what you're doing?
It's not that. He don't. But it ain't that.
What then?
I told him about Dean hitting me and things. I just wanted to get my own back on Dean. I didn't think anything had come of it.
Joke, innit? Some little scrap off the street would be treated better than this.
Hey, count your blessings. You haven't been handed the 163 yet?
Well, good as. Half the Knicks got me down as guilty already.
But only half. I've heard they're offering odds of 10 to 1 on. Well, are you?
What?
I'm asking you what you want me to believe, Len. If you're telling me that Karen Bevis dreamt the whole thing up, that she's got a grudge or something, then fair enough.
Why not?
Because it won't stand up. Then it's not up to me, is it?
Cheers, Ray. Thanks a lot.
Look, a lot of people around here think you're well overdue. They won't be shedding any tears. If you want me to help you, then you've got to start giving me something.
It's not like she said, Ray. It's nothing.
I've been asking around, Len. 2 months ago, another complaint.
That was withdrawn.
Night shout. Furniture store. Suspects on. Keyholder arrives back to find you and Karen Bevis doing quality control on some rolls of carpet. Is that nothing as well?
She set the driver up, sir. Played for sympathy. My pimp's beating me up stuff. Seems the driver's got a soft spot for her.
So he goes hurtling round to have a go at Cochrane. Have you told her yet?
Oh, yeah.
Well, here's some more news for her. Cochrane's just discharged himself from St. Hugh's.
You are?
So we better find that cab driver before Cochrane does. Before we've got another murder on our hands.
You're telling me that Karen was a willing party?
We both knew it meant nothing. I'm married. It was a giggle, that's all.
Oh, so it's been going on for a while.
Yeah. I didn't force myself on her. She came back for more often enough.
No pressure.
Well, if anybody wanted out, it was me. You know I'm on, like, a suspended at home. I couldn't afford for it to get heavy.
So that's what her bad report was. An easy way to get her off your back.
Just started telling the truth, that's all.
Come on.
Out. Now.
But he was messing about with her.
Well, not in the way she's putting it over, no, sir. It's been going on for a couple of months. She's never complained before.
And you think that's acceptable, do you?
I'm not condoning anything, sir. But I don't think it's a disciplinary matter.
No?
No, sir.
I'll bear that in mind.
Do we have to? It's like when someone's died. You never know what to say, do you? Do you mind?
So how's it going then?
Oh, fine. Sorry.
Suppose the word's got around.
Oh, you know what it's like.
What do you think I should do, June?
Look, it's not my decision. I'm sorry.
Left it a bit late for advice, Karen.
How do you mean?
Well, harm's done, isn't it? You should have sorted it out yourself, not gone running upstairs.
Polly?
Well, it's true, though. Just give some ammunition. All those blokes who think Plonk's are second-class coppers.
Well, what else was I supposed to do?
I don't know. Not this, though. This just makes it look bad for the rest of us.
Where's Dean, Jackie? My guess is he's after the driver. Revenge.
Dean won't bother. He won't go after that wimp.
Well, that wimp cared about you, Jackie. Enough to put himself in danger.
Never asked him to. Kept on like we were friends or something, poking his nose in. I'm not his daughter or nothing.
No.
Dean ain't gonna hurt him. He's not violent.
You told us yourself.
Only sometimes. When I do things wrong. When I deserve it.
It's not just you, Jackie. I've talked to other girls. Been to hospital with them. It's only a matter of time before he kills someone.
No.
You don't like prostituting yourself, do you? What happens when you've had enough? You won't be able to get rid of him. He'll come after you.
I love him.
Tell me the name of the minicab driver, Jackie.
He's a packie. Mr. Arna. Said if ever I was in trouble to give him a ring.
What's this, sir?
Notes for guidance. The grievance procedure. Take them home, have a read.
Sir?
I'm agreeing with you, Bevis. You've got a case. Sergeant Keegan displayed unprofessional behaviour towards you.
Thank you, sir.
Right. Tomorrow, 9 o'clock, we'll get the paperwork done.
What happens then, sir?
Chief Superintendent Brownlow will see a copy of your complaint, as will the Equal Opportunities Unit, possibly the DAC. It'll be their decision whether to initiate disciplinary proceedings against Sergeant Keegan.
But surely it's my decision, sir. I mean, how far I want to go.
Not if it's a serious disciplinary offence, no. Unless you're saying you don't want to proceed.
No.
Fine, tomorrow then.
What about Sergeant Keegan, sir?
The service won't tolerate sexual harassment, Karen. We're looking at a dismissible offence.
Sacked, you mean? I never meant it to go this far.
How far did you mean it to go? Teach him a lesson, was that it?
He was in the wrong, sir. He used the stripes.
And you?
You think I encouraged him?
You tell me.
All I ever did was try to fit in.
Try to be one of the lads. It's not always that easy, though, is it? You hang around with them, Karen. Have a drink with them. All quite innocent.
Well, why shouldn't I? I just thought I was staying in with them. Len saw it as something else, that I was available.
By which time you were too far in to say no. Go away. Have a think.
I have, sir.
Mr. Rana, I was out in the pickup. You just missed him. Okay, Charlie, thanks.
Who is he collecting?
A girl. Jackie Toohey. She rang about 10 minutes ago.
I bet it. She's still down at the station.
Cochrane.
Yeah, he would have got one of the other girls to ring in.
She asked for Mr. Rana specifically. Said he always drives her.
Where was the pickup from?
Hotel. One of the rotty ones. Only hotel.
But can you contact Mr. Rana? Tell him not to make the pickup. It's extremely urgent.
I can't do that. His radio's dead. Has been for days.
Don't know why you're in a strop.
Oh, can you believe that? He didn't even look.
Be honest, if Keegan had tried it on with you, you'd have sorted it.
Well, it still doesn't make my way right and hers wrong.
All units from Sierra Oscar.
Well, maybe it's my way that makes the blokes think they can get away with it.
Attention call to a beige Nissan Stanza.
Driver's a Mr. Rana. It's a minicab. CID want him intercepted before he reaches the Home Lee
Hotel.
Sierra Oscar from 85.
Go ahead, Polly.
I think it's just cut us up, Sarge. Heading east down Jarrow Road. We're turning now.
They'll have to go some, Sarge. Oak Road cuts off Jarrow Road. The hotel's just over the roundabout.
What units have we got free?
The RT cars in the area, sir.
Right, we'll get them down there and give Polly and June some backup.
Sierra Oscar from 85.
Go ahead, Polly.
Yeah, we found the minicab, Sarge.
Hey, Polly? Mr. Rana? Can you hear me?
Sierra Oscar from 85. We're going to need an ambulance at the hotel, Sarge. Oi! Oi, mate! June, there's no way out! Round that way!
Right, stay right where you are! Now put that down! Come on!
Come on, mate, just calm down.
Alright, come on. Just keep this nice and calm, eh? Keep it calm. Yes. Nothing's gonna happen.
Yeah.
Come on!
Oi!
Ah! I was lying.
And that's it. A slag changes a story and I'm supposed to be happy.
No. Grateful, maybe. She could have buried you.
I don't owe her a thing. She tried to stitch me.
And she didn't have good reasons. Bailing you out cost her.
So? I'm grateful, Ray. I'll do the same for you one day.
No, you won't. I don't know why Cato bothered.
Expediency, Ray. They need sharp-end coppers. And he's honest enough to admit it.
Just do us both a favour. Get out of here.
You what?
Just do it.
Yeah, you did well. How about you? Have you come to a decision yet?
More or less.
Have to serve out a month, of course.
Look, there's still time to change your mind, you know. You could ask for a transfer to another relief, another Nick even.
Why should I? Be like I was the one in the wrong, wouldn't it? No, I'm better off out of it altogether.
Worth sleeping on?
Maybe. No. Who needs the aggro, eh, June?
I don't smell the scent of victory, Ray.
Oh, you surprised, sir?
Intrigued, that's all. Doubt if Sergeant Keegan shares your misgivings.
That's one way of putting it. He's probably over the road now, sir, getting him in.
Yeah, well, I hope he does save at the moment. It won't happen again.
Sir?
I don't like losing young officers, Ray. Leaves a taste.
I'd agree with that one.
Keegan should get a lock on this. He's going to be needing it for a while yet. He's going nowhere, Ray. Not in this nick. Not if I have anything to do with it.